we planned this 2020 vision, the idea was that the works would be connected not necessarily by a musical or any philosophical idea, as they often are in our programs. But here it would be a purely coincidence, almost a random coincidence. We would find works which were composed in the same year of different centuries. And the main point was to review the first 20 years of the 21st century. Basically, each year would be represented by a work by a living composer, which was composed in that year, starting in 2001 and finishing in 2020. So these last three concerts are the last three installments of this 2020 Vision Festival. And they are treating the years 2018, 2019, and 2020. So in the first concert, the central work, the work of our century, is the piano concerto by Yelena Katz-Chernin, the Russian-Australian composer. And this concerto is dedicated to Johann Sebastian Bach's first wife, Maria Barbara, who untimely died in Bach's absence while Bach was on some concert tour. And tragically, we know that when Bach returned home, he found that his wife was not only dead, but already buried. Obviously, there was no telephone, no means of communication in those days. The composer was trying to imagine what was happening inside Bach's soul. And what came out was this piano concerto, written for an Australian pianist, Tamara Anna Chislovska, who unfortunately, due to COVID-19 regulations, was not able to travel to UK from Australia. So we found a young Romanian pianist, Alexandra Silocea, who agreed to learn this concerto on 5-day notice. So it was a really big drama around preparation of this concerto. But we were very lucky to have had her and having been able to retain the concerto in the program. And the works built around it were the works from 17, 18 and 19, 18. So this program, we decided to leave the 19th century alone because we simply haven't found any great works which were composed in 18, 18. Sometimes it happens that the year was poor for classical music. But 1718 was the year when Johann Sebastian Bach, the, so to speak, protagonist, the hero of the concerto by Katz-Chernin, when he wrote his first orchestral suite. But the first suite is highly interesting musically. So the suite is in C major, and my idea was to pair it with another C major work from 1918, George Enescu's Third Symphony, which is a massive work with a huge choir and organ and children's choir. And unfortunately, due to COVID situation, we couldn't perform a symphony. But we felt it was important to retain the name of Enescu, as one of the eminent composers of the 20th century, and the one for whom we have done a lot at the LPO already. We decided to find two works which are rarely performed. They're not from 1918, one predates 1918, and the other one was written much later, in 1954. In fact, it was the very last composition of Enescu. So the first one is Decet for 10 winds, two flutes, two oboes, two clarinets, two bassoons, and two horns. A very beautiful, romantic work, still written under the influence of Johannes Brahms and Antonín Dvořák. And the later work is the Chamber Symphony for 12 players, which shows the most mature late style of Enescu. And this is like a testament, a personal testament of an artist. I think the work deals with issues of war and peace and the survival of human spirit under impossibly strenuous conditions. And I found that this work would be the best possible conclusion for our concert. So although we haven't kept it with the year 18 entirely, the overall concept still remained intact with the work by Bach from 1718, Jelena Katschanin from 2018, and at the end, two pieces by Enescu, one of which at least speaks to us directly in 2020, and this music means a lot to me personally.